welcome everyone to our celebration because it really is a celebration for us. We're always very, very proud on Move Up Days, and it's really exciting for us this year because we have such a large 8th grade group. I think this is our largest ever with 27, so it's a really large class for us. A couple little housekeeping things. We are a very inclusive school, which is one of the things that I think makes us special. And one of those is some of our students really struggle with lots of noise. So for those students, when they're introduced, because students have chosen someone who's going to introduce them to give them the certificates, if the teacher goes or the staff goes like that, for that person, that's a sign language sign for clapping. So please, for those students, if somebody goes like that, don't clap like that. Clap like that so it makes less noise, and that way they'll tolerate the service more. I would like to introduce some folks. I would like to start by introducing SES staff. Wherever you are in the room, please stand because we could not be here without all of your help. So SES staff, please stand. I would like to welcome Mr. Santos from the school committee to say a word. Okay.
Morning. My name is Melquisedec Santos. I'm a school committee member. I come to here to say congratulate every kid. I want to continue help the community. I'm new in the school committee member, but I want to learn and do something for people who can help. I want to help too. I appreciate for parents and come over here to say congratulate your children. Thank you for coming. I want to see more kids practice and doing the best thing for Lawrence. Sorry. I appreciate the cooperation for people understand. Sometimes people don't speak English like me, I think. But I want to say thanks for understand the situation. But in the future, maybe we can do more and more for the city of Lawrence. Thank you, and appreciate for teacher, member, the staff member, everybody help Lawrence. We appreciate that. Thank you for everything. Thank you. Bye-bye.
I would like to introduce some very special people who have worked with the 8th grade. So 8th grade staff, would you stand? Because you've done a remarkable job this year. So the teachers that are here, Miss Melissa is somewhere in the building. So without all of their help, we would not be able to make it through all of this.
Thank you.
We agree.
Thank you.
So we're going to start this ceremony today with our 7th graders because our 7th and 8th graders do a lot together. So we're going to do 7th grade certificates to promote them to 8th grade. And then we're going to get right into the stuff that everybody wants to see, which is your sons and daughters move on up through the high school. So 7th grade teachers, Miss.
So we're just giving awards to the 7th graders that they've earned. They're moving up to 8th grade, and we just want to recognize them. If we can just hold the applause for all of them till after, because we have a bunch of them. So when I call your name, please come up and get your awards. The first two awards go to Joshua Garcia for strength in science and his sense of humor. Come on, Joshua. The second two awards go to Winzy Gonzalez for his effort in history, as well as always lending a helping hand. Winzy also received two more awards. He actually has a total of four. One is for his increase in his reading score for his math test. He went up 261 points. And he also received an athletic award from the physical education teacher, Ms. Jackie. Theron Cousins, you've received an overall improvement award for your behavior as well as your effort. Devon Davis, you've received an overall effort award as well as improvement in reading. Next, we have Ronnie Polanco. Ronnie has received four awards, too. One for his athletic award in physical education from Miss Jackie. One for improved all-around effort. One for an excellence award in English language arts. And you've also increased your math score for math testing this year. Christian Santos, he has received three awards. One for recognition of outstanding work in math, one for excellence in language arts, and he has also received an athletic award from Miss Jackie. Henry, where are you? You received an award too. You received two awards. One for being a teacher's pet, Miss Sue, right? And one for trying it so hard when you read. So we're very proud of you for that. So congratulations.
Good job on that.
Brian Ainoa. Brian's received a science award and his improved effort in ELA. Chris Urena, you've also received a Teacher Pet Award. Mr. Jeremiah is not here, but that one's for you, as well as your improved behavior. Be careful. Luis De Jesus, you've received an award for being helpful because you always help out when Miss Sue needs help or when anybody else needs help. And also, Mr. Yates wanted to give you a math award because you've done really well in math. Oh, Lewis, and you increased your reading score for math testing by 150 points. So good job. Adonis Serrano, you have gotten an excellent penmanship award because you probably write neater than even the teachers here. You've also received an award to be able to let go and move on. AJ, you have received an award in performing arts skills as well as a personality award because you have such a lovely personality. And you have a reading award because you went up 160 points in your reading test. And Isaiah, we have a return award because you just came back to us. Where did he go? So that is for Isaiah. So thank you very much. Good luck next year in eighth grade.
All right. She stole my program. I have more seventh graders.
I'm going to call my seventh graders up for awards. Hang on. Okay, my first seventh grader I am going to call up is Joseph Morse, and he got an award for most improved writing, and he got one for improved reading comprehension, and he also got an award for his artistic ability in the classroom. Congratulations. The next student I am calling up is Rafael Reyes. And Rafael is getting an award for most improved reading. He is also getting an award for his math progress, and he's also getting one for his artistic ability in class. Congratulations. And the next student I'm calling up is Aaron Roman. And Aaron is getting one from me for his athletic ability. He is getting one for his improved reading in class. He's getting one from Miss Jackie for physical education. And he is also getting an award for improved writing. And he's also getting one for his ability to care about others in the classroom. So congratulations. And next is Jose Rosado. And Jose is getting awards for his progress in math. He is getting one from Miss Jackie for physical education. He's getting another one in our class for exemplary behavior because he has been on level four for I don't even know how long. And he's done an amazing job. And he's also getting one for helping others because Jose is always willing to help other people out and he always asks what he can do to help other people. So congratulations.
All right, so now we're going on to our eighth graders, and we've asked two eighth graders to come speak. So our first is Miss Raven Clark. Raven?
Today I am up on this podium to speak about my eighth grade year at the SCS Middle School. I arrived in the middle school of the year around November, and that's when I met the teachers and the students. For me personally, this school year was the best school year. It was trouble-free and I made great people here. At this time, I would like to talk about the eighth grade staff and the teachers have been supporting eighth graders to the end. Mr. Yates, my first homeroom teacher, funny, insanely exciting, and so much more. Our math teacher, the one who would do weird stuff, oh boy, that was him. Mr. Yates was the best math teacher when I needed help. He was there to save me. He always did funny stuff. One day he said there was going to be a second me in me. He always did funny stuff. Wait, ooh, my bad. Second me in the class. A few days after, there he was. Two Mr. Yates, even though one was enough. Those videos he made. Get back to work, pay attention, funniest thing ever. It was a pleasure to have you as my math teacher and you will be missed. Mr. Ray, my second homeroom teacher, I was transferred over to you, my history teacher. Where do I start? You did a lot for the eighth grade students and we appreciate this. Mr. Ray was one of my favorite teachers. He was very calm and cool, never raised his voice, not once. He is full of jokes and always said nice things about us, never said anything bad about his students. The history he taught us was very informative. He taught everything well and made sure we understood everything. It was very memorable to have you as my history teacher and my homeroom teacher. Mr. Elvis and Miss Colleen, together they teamed up as our crisis aid and helped us achieve our goals, whether that was a simple talk or walk to cool off, just sitting with us in class, helping us with our work, easy advice. For that, we sincerely thank you for all your efforts. They will always be appreciated. In the beginning, it was rough. In the middle, it got a little easier, and we finally made it to this day because of staff and us, our students. Our accomplishments we achieved today set up us for the future for tomorrow. I want to thank every single person, teachers, staff, administrators, parents, and especially the graduating eighth class of 2013. Lastly, I want to say, wait. Lastly, I want to say, we can only set ourselves to limits, so in that case, don't ever limit yourself because our limits are endless.
Angel Morales.
Welcome, everyone, and thank you all for coming. I'm here today to congratulate 8th graders on their graduation to high school. This is big for us 8th graders. Every single one of us knew this day would come. This day will be recognized as the day we accomplish middle school, the day we make something of ourselves, the day we plan for the future. Middle school has been rough, but also been exciting. There were bumps in the road, but instead of giving up, we kept on going. We 8th graders are going to face responsibility. In high school, there are no teachers holding your hand. It's you and only you. There's no getting what you want for free. You have to work for it. There are no easy things in life. You have to push for what you want. I've learned that through struggles in life, all of us have. But you can fix that. Anyone can. Us humans are made to withstand struggles and situations we can't handle because we can fix these problems. In time, anything heals. So 8th graders, prepare for your beginning of a new chapter unfolding, high school. This is your life, you can make a difference. And thank you all for coming and congrats 8th graders.
Well, I know if I don't know if I want to really want to do my speech now after the two of them, but I will. 2 minutes and it's over. And then we get to the important stuff. So, good morning, everyone. I have to say, 8th grade moving up ceremonies bring lots of emotions for many of us. It's a time for looking back as well as looking forward. I and the staff have had the privilege of spending many years with some of these students here today. They're a tremendous group of young people. This class is both unique and very special. They are unique in their accomplishments as a class, and in their individual academic and social endeavors. They have met standards that future SES middle school classes will look to surpass, and it's going to be pretty hard for them to beat it. They are future students at Lawrence High School, Greater Lawrence Vocational Tech, and SES. But most importantly, they are a class of independent young people, and that's what makes them so special. They have survived some difficult times, and even in crisis, they have stayed the course by remaining resilient and unified as a group. As a class, they are leaving middle school a little stronger than when they entered. They've learned how to cope. They've learned how to give back. They've definitely learned how to turn to each other in their times of need. This class of 27 students who arrived here today, through it all, they've always been special because they've known how to be compassionate, and they're always looking at the needs of others and respecting and caring about their friends. They truly celebrate each other. Stories are really what makes a memory. In your future years, I hope they can look back at stories they've lived through in middle school. And they're gonna be able to share it with their friends, their families, and someday with their children. And these stories are not gonna be about math. They're not going to be about the English that Miss Truville taught them or about the Visigoths that Mr. Ray taught them. They're going to be other stories. And these stories are what memories are made of. Hopefully they'll remember their lunch at Cafe Azteca. I know I'm going to remember Henry being soaked at Canopy Lake forever yesterday. And Isai being fearless on the ropes course at Camp Otter. Walt Disney, the ultimate story maker, once said, "You can dream, create, design, and build the most wonderful place in the world, but it takes people to make a dream a reality." These guys have made a lot of dreams real. And over the years, they have grown as students, as people, and have become these great people we see today. They've made some great decisions and made a number of mistakes over the past years. But today I can tell you, that you've made it to the end of middle school. For some, it was easier than others. And I can tell you, as a staff, you've made us angry, you've made us laugh, but at the end of the day, we'll always be smiling because of this eighth grade class of 2013. Today, the middle school chapter of your life ends, but there are many more chapters ahead. Remember to continue to have stories in which memories will be based. Remember to always have fun, and remember to laugh. I know in my heart that the story for all of you has truly just begun. Good luck to all of you. Thank everyone for being here, and we will miss you as you go on to high school. And I know you will continue to shine in the years ahead. So from myself and the staff, congratulations to our class of 2013. First award to eighth grade. Actually, it's a principal's award. I have to tell you, I struggled on who to give this award to. I was texting people last night at 7, 8, 9 o'clock going, who do you think? The principal's award is not about who's the best student. It's not about who's the best athlete. It's not about any of those things. It's about who overall is a student that is caring, is kind, always works hard, always takes the needs of others into account when they're doing things. And I really struggled, but at the end of the day, I decided to choose Mr. Mickey Ortiz. All right. Unlike other schools, our presentation ceremony is very individualized. So the students have all chosen people they would like to introduce them. So we're going to start that in about 30 seconds. Before I do, though, our content coach has made it very clear to let me have you know that our preliminary MCAS scores came in for ELA, and actually, three of our students up here actually scored exceptionally well. Scored proficient or higher. So with these three people, please stand. Chanel Mejia, Angel Morales, and Fabian Santiago. First presenter, Miss Laura. Miss Laura.
Student that's graduating is Louis Albino. Louis entered the SES school mid-year from New Jersey. When we first met Louis, we recognized his cooperative nature and willingness to help others. Louis has been a great asset to the classroom. He's always eager to learn and teach others what he knows. In addition to being a hard worker, Louis has many wonderful goals for himself in the future. Louis is a kind, caring, and compassionate young man who's always willing to lend a helping hand to others. We wish Louis the best of luck in his new chapter in his life. Louis has also earned some certificates, one for most improvement in reading, and another one for creativity in artistic ability and in drawing. So we want to present Louis with his eighth grade diploma. Congratulations. The next presenter is Tom Yates.
This one works. Okay. There are traits I have assessed about Jose as my mathematics students this year, which will work for him in his future endeavors. One is his concentration. Jose had an enviable ability to focus on any puzzle, class assignment, or the beginning of the class due now. The tasking wasn't done until it was done. Then there is his knowledge of his math facts, not only knowing his multiplication facts, but also his division. As second nature as the street names in his neighborhood, and is half the battle of mathematics victoriously won. The rest is just learning how to use the symbols. I am proud to have had Jose as my homeroomer all school year long. As I've also taught high school mathematics, my advice to Jose to follow for his future in high school mathematics is to hang on to those math facts like a lifeline. When navigating high school algebra, follow your order of operations knowledge, especially when those equations get really, really long. Simplifying simplifies. Something called the equation of a line is not going to go away. It will be your skills learned in middle school math that will be your handholds and footholds when climbing ever higher in mathematics. Commence your life, Jose. You're on your way to earning success. Okay, he won some awards. His effort in English, he got a star award for effort in English, and he also got an effort in science, and he had an athletic award for Jose, and he increased his MAP scores by 78 points. So congratulations. Next presenter is Susan Lassar.
Tupac Shakur, to live is to struggle, to survive is to find the meaning in your struggle. Ladies and gentlemen, Japandison Anderson. Japan has also achieved some other awards for effort in history. The next presenter is Erin Lair.
He clearly knows that this is for him. I have known Jacob for many years and have had the pleasure of being his teacher for this year. Jacob is a fun, energetic student with a great sense of humor who always puts a smile on everyone's faces. He has done a nice job overall following the rules and routines within the classroom, being helpful if it's things that he likes to do. If it's nothing he likes to do, we have a little more difficulty. But he gets it done, and that's good. He has done a really beautiful job and is very excited. So Jacob is earning our certificate. Jacob is earning a certificate for accepting responsibility for his behaviors. Clearly he does. And he is also earning a super student certificate for improved social skills and peer interactions. He has really done a great job being able to play games with his peers and take initiative with some of the other kids, and we have seen a real lot of great interactions and had a lot of fun times with our friend Jacob. And you are also getting your middle school diploma.
Thank you.
Thank you. Here you go, buddy. And our next presenter is Alicia Boucher.
Hi everyone, I am Mrs. Boucher. I am here to congratulate Devin Brunette on finishing the eighth grade. He has been a very hard worker this year. He's been basically my right-hand man whenever I need help in the classroom. He's always willing to help me out, and he's willing to help out any of his classmates, whether it's play a game with them or walking with them in the hallway. He's an excellent example for everybody in my class. Devin, come on up. He has a couple of awards today. Okay, Devin is getting an award from Miss Jackie for PE. Excellent job in PE this year. Devin is also getting an award for always willing to help. He has shown his willingness to always lend a helping hand to anyone in the classroom, including peers and the staff members in class. Nice job, Devin. And Devin also is getting an award for improvement in his academic skills. Devin's come a long way with being able to sit and kind of focus on his work and not needing to always call me over for help. He's learned how to problem solve and how to do some things on his own, which is excellent. And then Devin's also earning his diploma. Nice job, Devin. The next presenter is Ray Machado.
Oh, okay. Thank God for modern technology, by the way, because this one speech is sitting on my desk in my office at home. So I luckily had an email to myself already. Our next graduate is kind of been a staple here at SES for a long time. I'm not sure who's been here longer, him or Dr. K. From a little butterball of an elementary school student to the tall eighth grader that sits behind us today on stage, he has been involved with so many of the staff and students who are either in this room, upstairs doing whatever they need to do right now, or they've gone on to other things. Even though he hates to admit it, he's very intelligent, doing extremely well on many of his classes and state tests. But it's not cool to be smart, and he'll try to convince us otherwise. That's him, growing from a little boy into the average defiant teenager that sits up on the stage today and we see. And we all love, like a pesky little brother or your grandmother's chihuahua that barks everything it sees. We're actually proud to see him transition to high school. You know, we're gonna miss him a great deal. It's my pleasure to introduce to you Mr. Alex Calzada. Alex is being honored today in other areas for excellence in artistic skills as well as excellence in mathematics, so put your hands together for that as well. I'm going to turn it over to Colleen Barry.
And I will be passing it off to Ray.
Annunciation works real well. And I swear this next one came back just for eighth grade week. You know, he was here for a while and then disappeared and magically returned when it came time to go to Camp Otter and Canopy and movie trips and out to lunch at Cafe Azteca. Into whip dodgeballs at my head. I don't know what it was. Could have been the school he attended and didn't have anything fun for him, or it could be that he truly missed us all, but he's here now. We gotta honor him for what he has done. Sorry. When his past teachers talk to me about this graduate, we always say have positive things to say. He gets it. That's what one colleague recently told me when we talked about him when the student recently returned. I go on forever explaining what it is, but he might get it, but I don't. Really, this student is extremely perceptive to the world around him. You know, add his common sense to his intelligence, and you get one of the brightest students to walk the halls here at SES. It's going to be difficult to say goodbye to this one again. Give it up for Nathan Cruz. Nate's being honored for really holding it together before he left and when he came back, kind of what we call his resurrection. So that's what the one award he's getting along with his diploma. Give him a round of applause again. And I'm going to hot potato it back to Colleen.
Let's hope it works this time. Okay. Christian DeRock. For everyone who knows or doesn't know, I've been here for 7 years. Christian Drock has been here longer. He knows my boss, he knows our staff workers longer than I have. Christian started off here as a baby. If you ask Mr. Ray, he still is a baby. But he's a baby to us because we've watched him grow from a peanut into a young man. For those of us who have been here for a long time, watching him walk across this stage today is like watching one of our own children move on to the next stage of his life. It's happy and sad at the same time. One thing Christian developed here is the ability to let go and move on. He always shows that he cares about all of us. He's proved that he has the ability to handle himself like a young man in some of the roughest situations. We will miss you, Christian. Please put your hands together for Christian DeRock. Christian's getting his diploma, an Improved Effort Excellence Award, and Behavior Turnaround Excellence Award. Congratulations. I believe it's going back to Ray.
No?
Maybe not. Laura, I apologize, Laura.
Next student is Louis Disla. Louis Disla has been with me through this whole school year, and it has been a pleasure to watch him grow up and mature into a young adult. He has made amazing strides this year, both academically and with his behavior. Louis is currently on level 4, and he's been there for a few months now. Louis is amazing. He is always willing and eager to help both his peers and staff all day long in the classroom. He is always there when someone is struggling. He's always there with a helping hand, asking if he can help someone, what can he do for us. He's socially and behaviorally, he's done wonderfully in the classroom. Louis is always there to compliment others or there with a kind word when someone just needs it and he sees that someone might be upset. Louis has become a peer model in the classroom. It's been a pleasure and an honor to have him as a student this year, and we wish him the best of luck in high school. Louis has also earned some awards. He has earned one for increasing his reading skills, 50 points on the MAP test, this past testing. He's also earned one for his incredible creative writing skills. And, hold on a minute, they are stuck together. He's also earned one for excellent behavior in the classroom and in the school. So congratulations, Louis.
Especially on learning how to focus on his work while he's at his seat and not having to continuously talk and ask questions about other things. Andy also is extremely friendly in the morning. Every morning I can count on Andy coming in and being the first student to say good morning to me in a really sunshine way. So Andy has done an excellent job this year. Andy has a couple of awards here. One is the award for being most friendly, for always greeting staff and students with a friendly hello and a smile each day. The other award is for Andy improving his independent work skills. He's come a long way in being able to focus on his work, and Andy, I'm very proud of you. Congratulations, Andy. The next presenter is Mr. Ray. Oh, I'm sorry, it's Ms. Lear.
My next graduate I get to talk about is Christian Javier. I have had Christian in my class a long time ago when, again, he was much younger and just starting out in our program. And I have been fortunate enough to have him in my class and be his teacher for the past 3 years. Christian has turned into a wonderful young man. He always does a great job being a peer helper. He has improved tremendously with his ability to express himself if he's frustrated and be able to make some positive choices to be able to deal with frustrations and just things that occur in our everyday lives. I can always count on Christian to do the right thing. He is a great listener and is just an overall wonderful young man. So Christian is earning some certificates. He got the one from Miss Jackie for gym for being a good team player. He is earning. Outstanding Student Award for his good decision making and being a good peer model to all of his friends. And he's also earning an Improved Academics Award. Christian has really done a lot of great work this year in all the areas of the curriculum that we do, increasing independence, math and reading, and just everything we give him, he's doing a really great job with. So congratulations, Christian. And now up is Mr. Ray.
Quiet, timid, shy, unconfident, anxious, sad, lonesome. None of these are attributes for our next graduate. First, he always has something to say. In actuality, it's kind of hard to shut him up at times. After all, he usually has a better answer than I do on stuff, anyway. Two, the only thing I've seen this student be afraid of is... Three, I think overconfidence is the correct term. That old cliche, sometimes they teach me. No, in this student's case, he actually gets his jollies off and proves me wrong. And he does it constantly. No, mister, square root of 613,089,783. And there I am. Carry the two. Four, five, and six, calm, collected, and with a joke to lighten up your mood. Not that it's a better, statement, although he was here for such a short time. He made a lasting impression in my career as an educator. Let's put our hands together for the one and only Stevie Marshall Carter. Stevie's got some accolades up here. First of all, 144 points in math testing, so he's getting honored for that by Ms. Butler. You also add in just a star award for his humor, as I pointed out, and also an excellence award, just overall improved effort across the board in all his classes. So congratulations to Stevie. I get the honor of presenting next to you too. Let Stevie go and grab some of these real quick. Every now and then, you're introduced to someone unique, someone who will always stand out in your memory. We should remember the really great ones and the really horrible ones for different reasons. Our next graduate is one of those really, really great ones. He didn't stand out from the pack for making us have to chase him across a building, or pitching a temper tantrum every time he was told no, or training for that school Olympic event that we like to call furniture tossing for distance. He surely never made me rock back and forth on my kitchen table, praying to the gods of every religion, past and present, to get rid of him. Oh, please. I can't take it anymore. I certainly never broke out dancing the cha-cha slide of the YMCA when I found out that he was absent. Actually, this student took one of the worst barriers for anyone who just arrived in America, his lack of understanding English, and he faced it head on. He overcame it, showing his strength in other areas. Through that, he became an ambassador of SES, always smiling and greeting everyone. He showed us that people are capable of enjoying the fact that they are living another day. He excelled athletically, being a beacon for our Greyhound basketball team. And in the end, he made SES a better place to be. Ladies and gentlemen, allow me to introduce Isai Martinez. He's waiting to ask me for two tickets to the Red Sox game, by the way. He's been hounding me for over a month. He said he's getting some accolades himself, too. He's got his diploma, obviously, on top of which he's just getting a certificate of achievement. You know, we always honor academics, but personality is a great therapeutic tool to help us better ourselves. So he's getting an award in his respect towards others. He's getting an award in school citizenship to go along with that respect. He's got achievement for 139 points in math testing improvement. And that's not all.
Miss Jackie is honoring Isaiah for the Athletic Award in Physical Education. Give it up for Isaiah. Jose Mejica, you need it up on the stage, man.
This individual for the last few weeks has been asking me, Mister, have you wrote your speech yet? Mister, have you wrote your speech yet? He went until last night. He asked me again, Mister, did you write your speech yet? I said, no, Angel. This one is coming from the heart. I had the opportunity, I'm probably the newest staff here to the SES, and I'm honored and I thank individuals like Angel Morales and the rest of the staff and all you parents for giving me the opportunity to work with kids like this. I'm really honored, and just the fact that an individual like that, his accomplishments, how he's growing to be a young man from where he started till now is a major improvement, and I'm really proud of him. And so is his staff here. So Angel, come up and get your awards. He got an award in science for effort in science. He got one for effort in mathematics. And where he's good in rebounding, Miss Jackie gave him an award in the athletic department. Congratulations and good luck in your future. We're going to get up here now, Mr. Dr. K, to present for me.
We got it,
okay. They got me confused because they went out of order. I was a teacher first, ABC order, and they messed me all up. So anyway. I'm actually going to speak from the heart as well, because this is a young man I met 3 years ago. And 3 years ago, I became principal of the Oliver as well as SES. And to do something a little different, I said, you know what, I want to go back and do counseling in the classrooms. So I said, I'll do sixth grade. I have not been in a classroom in 13 years. I have been an administrator and a psychologist, so I was like, that was a little frightening. But one of the first classes I went into for counseling, or social skills, I think is what we called it, I met this class with this one boy in it who would sit there, and he was very quiet, but he would always sort of come hang out near me. But he didn't talk much at first, very quiet and reserved. And then as the year went on, he got more talkative, and every once in a while I'd see him, and he'd sort of hang out for a few minutes. Later though, his family moved to another part of the city and he went to another school, and then he started here this year. And in this year, he's shown a lot of the qualities, again, that got him the Principal's Award. He's kind, he's compassionate, he's caring. He's resilient, he always works hard. And on top of that, I think the best description is he's just a wonderful young man who I know will do exceptionally well in his future. So it is my privilege to introduce Mr. Mickey Ortiz. And as he comes up. He gets his diploma, he gets a certificate of achievement for outstanding effort in all subjects. He gets a citizenship award. And I don't know, I think he paid Miss Jackie, but he's getting a phys ed award as well, so congratulations, buddy. So, Miss Felicia, you come up.
The next person I'm gonna congratulate is Michael Mazuka. The fact that Michael is here in the auditorium is a big accomplishment for Michael. The fact that he's up on stage and sitting here is even bigger. Michael's come a long way in willingness to try new things and try things that he didn't like before. I'm very proud of Michael. Michael, come on up with me. He has a couple of awards for today, too. Hi, Michael. Michael's doing a great job being up here. He probably would prefer that you're not clapping right now, just wave your hands instead. Michael is getting an award for improving his time management skills. Michael being able to sit down and do his work and complete his work, he's come a long way this year. Prior to this, he used to kind of just sit and do some of his work and not continue, and he's continued his work as the year's gone on. The other award that Michael's getting too is his cooperation award. Like I said, the fact that Michael's in the auditorium is a big step for him. The other thing is that Michael does not like getting his hair cut, but this year he's come a really long way in being able to sit and get his hair cut and be able to tolerate the clippers, which is a big improvement for Michael. Michael, I'm so proud of you. Congratulations. The next presenter up is Mr. Ray.
Our next graduate is an interesting one. Let's begin off. She's bright and motivated. She'll put her best effort forward to excel as best as she can. She isn't afraid to speak up for herself, which I was reminded of daily. This was the only student in my history here who would flat out tell me why she was upset and what she wanted in return. Trust me, anything less wouldn't be accepted. Her advocacy skills kind of brought her to an independent academic program midway through the year, and she continued to thrive. Her time with us was shifted, but she made a lasting impression. And we're proud to see her up on stage today, earning her right to high school. Give a warm welcome to Chanel Mejia. On top of her diploma, Chanel's being honored for all-around academics and her outstanding effort in history. But also, just as a reminder that Chanel also scored proficient in MCAS in ELA, so even though she has an award here for that, you should be proud of her for that. Give her a round of applause. I'm going to turn over to Ms. Lair.
The next student I'm going to talk about is Emmanuel Pinheiro. And again, I had Emmanuel a number of years back, and halfway through the school year, he moved out of the state. And so he's been gone for a while, and I think it was about October, we heard his name come back up, and he came back. So he moved back to Lawrence, and once again picked right back up in my class. So we had a long gap, but now he's back, and I've had this school year to really see him grow into a nice, wonderful, caring young man. He is loving and really is a fun boy. Young man, actually. He's grown into a wonderful young man. He is making a lot of really good choices, and I want to say from month to month, we've really seen a lot of changes with Emmanuel. So Emmanuel, come on up to get your certificates. So Emmanuel is going to get an Outstanding Student Award for his increased independence. Emmanuel has done a great job adjusting to the schedule and being able to transition throughout the building, within the classroom, and he really knows what he needs to do, and he takes the initiative to do it. Yeah, you're doing great. Emmanuel is also receiving a Super Student Award for his improved behaviors. You know, every child's different, and we go through different
situations and times in our lives where we're affected by things one way or another. And Emmanuel has gone through a lot this year, but he has really turned around his behavior and is able to accept redirection. He's able to accept not getting what he needs at the time, and being able to express himself and how he's feeling in the moment, and working on strategies to be able to deal with those feelings. So Emmanuel earns an Improved Behavior Award along with his diploma. So congratulations, Emmanuel. And next up is Miss Laura.
Well, this student, what to say about him? Angel Rodriguez. Angel has been with us as long as I can remember. We have watched him grow up from, I think, when he was probably about 7 or 8 years old to now. We have had such a privilege to watch Angel grow up from a little boy to the mature, kind, caring, and charismatic young man that he has become today. Throughout the year, Angel has shown potential to achieve great things. He has worked with the younger children in the school, helping them with reading, math, and gym. Angel's proven to be encouraging, compassionate, and a positive role model to the younger peers in the classroom. Angel has always offered to help all the other kids in my classroom with academics and with anything social that they have difficulty with. Angel is going to be a wonderful asset to the high school, and he is going to be sorely missed in my classroom. He has just been amazing this year in classroom. Angel also has earned, obviously, his diploma. He has also earned an award in reading. He has made incredible strides in reading this year and moved up into a whole new reading class. He's also earned an award in creative writing. His writing's incredible. Angel will sit and write pages and pages when asked to. He also earned an award from Miss Jackie for physical education. So Angel, congratulations and good luck. And the next presenter is Sue Lessard.
A few months ago, this young man tore in here like the Tasmanian devil. He was wrapped tighter than a dreadlock, and certain he was alone. He struggled at first with the idea. I'm sorry, I'm pacing myself. He's translating for his grandmother. That people, and I do mean everyone, were not capable of any possible redemptions. He feared us all, and to some extent still does. Over the last 6 weeks, he's let down his guard. He has allowed us the opportunity to get to know him. Although he has gained the ability to trust in our system and allow it to show him his endless possibilities, he has made incredible progress. He is charming and very funny, and most importantly, capable of so much. He's tenacious when he works and eager to learn. When I look at him, I think, when life gives you lemons, this young man will take them and make some limbes. My life is better for having had the opportunity to meet him. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Henry Rubiera.
So my last graduate holds a special place in my heart. I have known him again, as with many of my students, for so many years, and have had the pleasure of having him in my class and working with him closely, with him and his family, over the past 3 years. He's a happy, enthusiastic, fun-loving young man who is always willing to help his peers or staff, heat up our lunch, make soup for the other kids, and just, he takes initiative, and if it's something dealing with electronics, he's in. He'll get the movies ready, he'll make our lunch, like I said, and just really helpful and caring. So my student is Peter Ruiz. So Peter is earning an Improved Academics Super Student Award for all of his hard work throughout all areas of our curriculum this school year. And he's also earning a Citizenship Award for his helpful and caring behaviors and attitude that he shows throughout our classroom. And an Improved Social Skills and Appropriate Interactions Award. For some people who know Peter or who experienced him over the years, he kind of likes to keep to himself and not really engage in activities with his peers and classmates. But this year, he's really done a nice job being able to have social leisure time and share a lot of appropriate peer interactions with his friends. And he's also earning his diploma, so congratulations, Peter. And I'm sending it back to Laura.
Okay, and last in my classes, we all know him, Dylan Spiridione. Dylan has been with us since, I think, first grade, and I think everybody knows Dylan. Dylan has just been amazing this year, and he's been with me for the past year and a half now. I have to say, I don't know what I'm going to do in computers next year without Dylan as my buddy next to me, looking things up. It's going to be very boring in computers without him. Dylan has an amazing sense of humor and a wonderful smile. He has always expressed a great interest in working at the dollar store, in fashion, or with animals. Dylan has one of the biggest hearts of anyone I've ever met. He cares about everyone, and he's always there with a helping hand or a kind word. He thrives on positive reinforcement and has just one of the best senses of humor of anyone in our class. He's always there to joke around with, and he really loves when you tell him jokes or you just kind of harass him a little bit. He thinks it's funny. Dylan has shown great improvement in his behavior and his willingness to take responsibility for his actions. We wish Dylan the best of luck in high school next year, where he will continue to make progress towards his goals. Dylan has, one, earned his diploma. He's also earned a certificate for the most improved behavior and excellence in his math skills. So congratulations. And now it goes back to Mr. Ray Machado.
Three students are up on the stage today, so I want to take one moment and kind of just name them off. We had speeches ready to be presented, but they just weren't here. So, you know, take a moment to honor Fabian Santiago, Emilio Silva, and Jeremy Matos, please. Our final graduate, the actual final, not mine, is by far one of the biggest success stories in the history of our therapeutic program. The first time I saw this graduate, he was sitting in a hallway with a now former SES teacher, crying and yelling about something that had got him mad. I thought in my sarcastic manner, wow, who's spitting his breakfast cereal? Then as the year went on, One day I was taking a lunchtime stroll through the halls of SES to once again come upon crying and grunting and yelling from the same kid. I never really remembered his name, so to myself I referred to him as the Bull, especially as it became routine to see this kid in the hall having his regular anger sessions. The Bull grew and moved on, and I began to forget about him. At the beginning of every year, I take the previous year's yearbook and I look at all the upcoming seventh graders, you know, trying to see who I know at least. When this class came to seventh grade last year, there was this picture. Okay, I thought to myself, you were bound to teach this kid someday. Guess it's now. History class came, and he was respectful. He listened to my lecture. He put forth his best effort. I thought, hey, great day. Next day, same result. So on and so on. My recollection of the Bull was squashed in under a month. And it wasn't until last night that an emergency came up and I was asked to say something about this young man that I kind of remembered. I was like, oh, wow, yeah, that's right, he's the Bull, as I sat in my office and typing up a speech. He soared to level four and he put forth his best effort. Most of all, he respected his classmate and all the staff. And I realized that this graduate taught me how to not prejudge anyone. Because I could have thrown an entire 2-year relationship with this young man away on the idea that, you know, I had prejudged him from his years in elementary school. Not really understanding that we all grow and we all evolve into better people one way or another. I would have lost a chance to work with someone special had I gone by my prejudgment. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my honor and privilege to present our final graduate for today, Mr. Eddie Torres. That one got me. This is one to be truly missed. Like I said, he's another staple here. He's been here for a long time. Eddie's getting an award today. He's getting his diploma. He's getting a certificate for respect towards others. He's getting an award for being our resident 8th grade level 4. He should get an award for his awesome attire and a tuxedo t-shirt. I made fun before we started today. We're proud of him. Eddie, congratulations.
So would everyone please put a big round of applause to our 2013